There's a lot of public hype about cryptocurrency. The room here needs to understand more that for investors, investing in blockchain technologies and the infrastructure in many ways is more important.
The reason I think blockchain is really interesting is I think we sort of stopped innovating on the internet in the mid-90s. As all the money came onto the internet, we sort of gave up creating open protocols like SMTP and HTTP that formed the basis of the internet, and we started creating siloed applications on top of those protocols.
Easiest explanation to me for a blockchain is a journal, except unlike a typical journal, it's a journal that is a peer-reviewed journal. No one person can unilaterally write to it. You'd need a consensus among people to write something down or to make a change. And it sounds like a pretty straightforward problem, but if you don't know the other people on the journal committee, that's the problem that blockchain is solving.
A lot of the times there's these giant systems that exist, like economic systems and social systems, and to manage these systems, you need people and you need intermediaries, you need centralized actors. And for the first time, you can do that without those central actors and do it in a safe and secure way.
Centralized systems have the advantages of performance advantages, for example. It's easier to create a centralized system that can get to a great scale. The main advantage in my mind of decentralized systems is that third-party developers, merchants, media companies, users can contribute to the network, build on top of the network without fear that the network will take away what they've built.
The reason why it's important to have a decentralized mining network is because then entities can't go to miners and ask for them to create these blacklists that exclude participants or wallet addresses.
What blockchain technology allows us to do is finish the job. We need identity protocols, we need security protocols, the kinds of things that weren't built out in the late 80s and early 90s.
The fundamental thing that blockchain does for you is it allows you to align incentives like never before. And that is beautiful for improving systems as a whole.
It's important to understand that all of these platforms and technologies built on the blockchain are built with a token or some entity of value that can be used to incentivize network participation. So imagine if the day that Facebook launched, every user got one stock of Facebook. Would they then be incentivized to continue to use Facebook as other products came about?
I think identity and the fact that Facebook and Google, for the most part, and Apple control essentially our identities on the internet, that's a bad thing. And I think that blockchain technology, decentralized technology, maybe the greatest potential for it is to give us control of our identities and give us control of our data back.
You and I couldn't opt out of Equifax's data collection. That was mandatory for us. In a decentralized blockchain-based system, you can opt in and you can opt out.
If I am consistently good at servicing people who buy stuff from me, let's say I use Uber and I always get fives, I use or give Airbnbs and I always get highly rated, I use eBay and my ratings are high, the authority of can you trust me is something that ought to be open, portable, and owned by me, but they're not. They're stovepiped and owned by big companies.
Computing goes through eras. You know, you start with mainframes, then you get personal computers, then you get cloud, and then you get smartphones. I think what's gonna happen is that as people learn to keep their private keys locally, they're gonna start to learn to keep private other things locally. Maybe you still will have data in the cloud, but it's all gonna be encrypted in such a way the cloud provider can't even read it without your local private key.
I don't think everything will be decentralized. There's just some things that operate better centralized. Anything that needs customer service, like that just needs to be centralized. You can't decentralize customer service. That's a human-to-human interaction.
If you're excited about the intersection of markets, economics, game theory, money, computer science, distributed systems, this is a great place to spend your time, especially if you're willing to take a very long-term view.
If your firm isn't looking at blockchain technologies as a potential future of the way the internet moves in a decentralized way, I think you're missing out on a big investment opportunity.